praxis, and I've been here on site for about 2 hours so far. And in that time, I've finished up the floor joists, staining them up on the upper level up there. As you can see here, there's none of them are done yet. I still have more sanding work for the water stains and all that kind of stuff. I'll be getting to those later on. Also, while I've been here, I've been working on trying to figure out what was the issue with those massive electric bills. I mentioned the other day I had a $400+ and then a $300+ electric bill. Yesterday, when I left, I turned off all the breakers here and I noted the number on the electric meter. It was 4,665. When I got back here this morning, it was the same number. I was curious if it was going to go up overnight, if there was some kind of a phantom drain somewhere, but at least last night that wasn't the case. So I got here this morning and I ran the sander for about a half an hour. I was doing some sanding work, ran out and checked, and it went up by 1 kWh, which, you know, it's kind of hard to know exactly how much was used because it, you know, could have been just ready to click over or whatnot, but still, you know, not very much. After that, I turned on the electric heater. I had that run for 1 hour, and as expected, the number on the meter went up by 2 kWh because it's a 2,000-watt electric heater. So that's operating as it should. Even if I had that thing running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for an entire month, that's about, you know, round up to 25 hours. You know, you double that to 50, so that's 50 kWh a day. You know, rounding everything up. So 50 kWh a day times 30 days in a month, that's still only about 1,500 kilowatt hours. So there's still another 1,000 kilowatt hours hiding there somewhere. Plus, in addition to the fact that number is a rounded up number and I never had it running 24/7. So there's still something going on. I'm thinking about maybe having a some kind of like a, maybe a, I've got one of those game cameras that I might set up and just see if there's someone messing with the meter at some point. But I'm going to continuously just kind of log every day, turn everything off, and see if, like, overnight someday it's like, you know, 300 kilowatt hours suddenly appear on the meter. So I'm going to keep going with that. I'm still investigating it. It's an irritant that I got to deal with it, but, you know, it's something that I'd like to track down at some point because, you know, these massive, you know, multi-hundred dollar bills are, you know, I can take a couple of those, but I can't have those going ad infinitum out into the future. I also want to talk about what I'm doing here, you know, since I finished up the staining work. I'm doing some carpentry over here, but before I do that, you know, as I always say, you know, the runs on this camera are only 5 minutes, so let's put a cut right here. And now we're back. Except that I snuck around behind you and I'm on the other side. Isn't that clever? It's awesome. All right, so I'd like to put the cut in the middle just so I don't feel like I'm nervous that I'm going to run out of video, you know, when I'm telling you guys what I'm doing right here. I'm doing some trim underneath these windows, which is kind of, it's trim and it helps hold the wall together, and it's going to be a little extra support for the windowsills. I'm doing them with 2x4s, and I had the misfortune of picking a 2x4. The picking on the 2x4 is getting a little slim. I found one that wasn't all marred, because you're going to see the front of it, but after I got it all cut exactly the size, I noticed there was a little bit of a bow in it. So I'm going to be working on that bow. I have it so it's crowned up, like this, and I'm not sure if you can tell over here, but it's a little more than a centimeter dipping down on this side, and this needs to be brought up about a centimeter. And I want to show you guys how I did that, how I'm going to do that. I've already got it nailed in on that half, and I was kind of like just pulling it up as I was doing the nailing, but this centimeter here is going to be a little challenging. So what I've got for that is a couple of boards. I'm going to place a board down here. I think I only need two, but I've got extras. And let's see, what I'm going to do is get this board under here and then hammer it in. I'm going to hold it in place and hit this. And as this board is going in, it's making this one more vertical and it's raising it up. And I'm not necessarily looking here, but here for where that is flush. And right now at the moment, this nail here is flush, so I can sink this one in. Here, this nail looks like it needs to be brought up a bit. Now that one's flush. And this is so much easier than kind of struggling against it while you're nailing. And that one could come up a touch.
Alright, this one's ready to go in. Alright, and this is looking pretty good here. I'm going to pop in the top two and then knock this block off and do the bottom. It's overshot by a little bit, it looks like, but once I pop this block out of here, it's going to sink down a little, I'm sure. Take this guy out. It looks nice and straight, and I'll sink in these last ones. These guys here I have at a kind of downward angle because knowing that the board's going to want to pull down, you want to have the nails kind of digging more into the wood as opposed to pulling away. So I have these guys kind of facing down. So, got that one done there, one on top, two on the other sides. And then I think I'm going to do some putty work, get putty into all these nail holes, and I don't know, honestly, that might be it for the day. But inch by inch, things are moving forward. I'm starting to run out of stuff that I can do until I hear back from the plumber. I'm still waiting to hear back from the plumber to find out about exact dimensions. That's the way the whole project's been. So, you know, just keep calling them. That's it. Thanks for watching.